Good morning. Welcome to the worship service. As the coronavirus pandemic continues, again we come together through online service. I hope and pray that everyone is doing well. Even though we could not come together and meet each other, let us continue to care for one another through the calling or sending a card to somebody. As I asked, please send your greetings to me by email. You can do it by the video or just the voice. Or if you couldn't do it, just send a greeting message to me by email. Then I will share with all. We don't know when this pandemic will be ended. But let us continue to pray and care for one another. Let us begin our worship service with the singing, "Opening the Eyes of My Heart."
Oh,
Please join me in the prayer of the day. Sometimes our hearts ache within us, O Lord. Like those travelers on the Emmaus road, we feel the deep sadness about losing Jesus. Our sadness finds its roots in many things, and we feel as though we cannot escape it. It becomes a part and a parcel of our conversations. Deep within, our spirit longs for the release, and we silently cry. Forgive us when we close our eyes to your presence. Heal our brokenness. Bind up our wounds. Place us on the path of healing, and help us to be the people who will bring compassionate caring to others. For we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Today's Gospel lesson is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verse 13 through 35. It's about the story of the disciples on the road to Emmaus. Now, on that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk alone?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" He asked them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was the prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and beside all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of the angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of the heart to believe all that the prophet has declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, 'Stay with us, because it is almost evening, and the day is now nearly over.' So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took the bread, blessed, and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. And he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?" That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companion gathered together. They were saying, "The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon." Then he told what had happened on the road, and how he has been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. This is the word of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God. Today's scripture lesson is about the story of the disciples on the road to Emmaus. Cleopas and his friends were going to Emmaus from Jerusalem on Easter. While they walked, they met a stranger who was resurrected Jesus. He taught them about the Bible, And when he offered the communion, they realized that he was the Jesus. This story is very instructive for us. It tells us a couple of very important lessons, so I want to share them with you. First, it tells us how important what we have in our mind or thought. It is hard to understand how the two faithful disciples of Jesus could have to travel with him side by side without recognizing him. Maybe disappointment blinded their eyes and their heart to the truth. In Jerusalem, they had learned the devastating news about Jesus' death. Despite having heard about the humans and other disciples reporting that Jesus was alive, they continued to focus on their death. For them, it was still Good Friday, so they did not believe the resurrection of Jesus, and did not recognize that the stranger was Jesus. Like the disciples in this story, we too can miss the resurrected Jesus in our midst when we are preoccupied by something, like disappointments or anger or loneliness, etc. Second, this story tells us the importance of worship. They experienced along the road and at dinner in Emmaus changed their disappointment and hope. When the disciples heard Jesus blessing the bread for the meal and saw him break it and give it to them, they suddenly began to understand. They recalled the glory of Jesus in his last days. And they remembered how they had begun to gain new insight on the road, when Jesus has recalled for them the great stories of Israel's past, and compared them with himself. When they heard the word from Jesus, when they received the bread and the cup, began to understand and recognize the resurrected Jesus. Like the disciples, our experience on Sunday mornings and at other times in worship help us to recall the scriptures and place them in the extraordinary context of Jesus Christ. And the communion recalled us the powerful moment at the Last Supper, when he gave his closest followers bread and wine, his body and blood, to provide nourishment and meaning and direction. For having a fulfilled life, and it makes us to experience the presence and grace of Christ, word and sacrament. It is equally important and equally necessary for our spiritual health. We hear the scriptures and experience them interpreted for us. And we set out a specific context for the communion, in which we recall Jesus instituting the special meal, meant for each of us. Everything is focused on the love of God. And lastly, this experience re-empowers us to walk with the resurrected Jesus throughout the rest of the week, at work and home, at school and play. When Cleopas and his companion began to realize that they had experienced the resurrected Jesus, they recognized that their hearts had been burning and he taught them on the road. They responded to their experience by going to Jerusalem to tell the others. Like the disciples on the road to Emmaus, we can overcome our disencouragement, our sense of lost, when we recognize the risen Christ in our lives. Our hearts can be burning with joy. Then we can overcome our discouragement, anger, and loneliness. And like the disciples, in our life, in our action, and in our word, we can reach others, helping them understand the presence of the resurrected Jesus. Can we open our eyes and hearts to recognize the resurrected Jesus in the experience of our lives? Or will we still focus on disappointment, marriage, and death? Will we too feel our hearts burning when we are taught or hear the word of God? And when we encounter the resurrected Jesus in our midst, will we respond in joy and faith and commitment, as did the two men on the road to Emmaus? Will we respond by moving from where we are, renewed by the resurrected Jesus, and ready to meet the world head on, ready to face the risk and change that His presence allows? Will we do nothing and just add to the heap of escapism and apathy and negativities that characterize our societies? The disciples discover on the road to Emmaus that Jesus was alive again, that God's work begun in Him could go on among His followers. Can we become like them? Will our hearts to burn with the desire to use the power of the resurrected Jesus? Will we use this burning to empower us to reveal God's love to others, continuing His ministry? Through our acts of compassion and caring to help heal the broken world, I hope and pray that in your daily life, you experience the presence of our Lord, so that you can be ready to use the power of our God for His ministry. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, when we fall into the depression, when we lost hope, when we are missing something, You come to us and empower us. Even though we did not know You and we did not welcome You, You made us see in Your viewpoint and reconciled us with God. As You taught Your disciples about God's word and invited them into Your table, teach us and gather us into the word and the table, that we may realize and experience that we are right with God. Open our hearts and mind so that we are ready to recall Your presence and to be empowered by You to do Your ministry. Loving God, we thank You for being with us even in this pandemic situation. Even though we could not gather together physically, through the gift of the technologies, we come together to worship You through online. Now we pray for those who need Your help in our prayer. We continue to pray for those who have suffered by coronavirus and their family. Those who lost their loved one by the virus. Those who fight against it. And those who care for the patients. We also pray for those who are affected by this pandemic situation. Those who lost their job. Those who could not find their daily need. Those who were separated from their family. And those who feel the loneliness. Lord of all the life, have mercy on all the people. Be the present with Your loving and healing spirit. Most of all, even in the midst of the turmoil, despair, or the difficulties, help us to recognize Your presence within us, and help us to find Your peace. And now we continue to pray as Your Son Jesus Christ taught us, saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. By the power of God's love, we are changed, renewed, and saved. And by the power of God's love, we can rise up like the eagle. I hope everyone can stand up and rise up like an eagle in this difficult situation. Let us sing together, Power of Your Love.
Renew, flowing from the grace.
open your eyes and heart so that you can recognize that the risen Christ is with you. When you recognize His presence, you can overcome all the difficulties and you will be empowered by Christ to serve Him and His people. May the peace of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen.